What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the TerraForm Generator plugin. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. If you are tired of the vanilla Minecraft world, or if you're looking for a change of scenery, you could do things like find mods or plugins. But usually with this comes unwanted aspects as well, like actual changes to the gameplay. If you're looking for nothing more than to spice up the visual biomes and structures, then TerraForm Generator is the perfect plugin for you. Let's go over how to install and configure a new world with this plugin. Before we start, make sure you have a paper or Spigot server running to upload this plugin. Head to TerraForm Generator on Spigot and press the Download Now button to the right. Save this file somewhere easily accessible on your computer to use in just a minute, and then head towards your Apex server panel and stop the server. Click FTP File Access near the top left, log in, and then head to the Plugins folder. In the top left corner, press Upload, and on the next page, drag and drop the file into the upload area. Once it completely uploads, you can use the back button to return to the main FTP, which is where we're going to configure the new world. Now that you've installed TerraForm Generator on the server, it's time for you to generate a world. This is required to get the plugin working without issues, since using an existing world doesn't allow for new generation. The process differs depending on if you have multiverse enabled on your server or not. Inside of the main FTP directory, find and press edit for the bucket YML file. At the bottom of the settings in the file editor, you can use this code, and then you can replace the world name with whatever you want your world name to be. Press save at the top, and then you can use your server name at the top to return to the main panel, and scroll down to change world in the world section. In this prompt, enter that same world name value that you put in the file, and then select Change World. Afterwards, you can press Restart Now in the next pop-up to start generating it. Now, if you have Multiverse installed on the server, then this method is what you're going to want to use. After uploading the plugin, you can restart the server from the main panel to activate it. Once it comes online, make sure you are a server operator, and then join your world and use this command, replacing world name with anything that you want. Send it in the chat and then wait for it to complete. And once that's done, you can use the MVTP your world name command to reach your new world. Once you enter your newly created world, you're going to immediately notice the difference. Almost every single biome is custom with a ton of unique properties, from giant colorful trees to floating islands. Let's just say it'll be clear you're not in vanilla Minecraft anymore. This also goes for the random structures that you'll encounter, since these are also customized. Now that TerraForm Generator is enabled, there are a ton of new biomes added to the game. The first one is popular around low parts of the world, especially near the water. This land is muddy and only has mushroom trees with very little vegetation. It's not an ideal place to live for many players, as there isn't much to do in this specific area, but there tends to be a lot of passive mobs that spawn here, making it the perfect biome for farms. By far, one of the most beautiful places to visit are the cherry groves, where large, pink, dark oak trees scatter the plains. This biome is great for growing flowers and building, and these locations typically have rivers around them, adding to their aesthetics. Besides the new custom biomes from the plugin, the vanilla areas are still included, but these are completely changed to match the surroundings. For example, birch forests might have rocky trees with large mushrooms. Other ones include plains and normal forests that all have their own unique properties. As for the randomized structures to encounter in your new world, these tend to stick to vanilla buildings. In other words, the plugin doesn't necessarily add new ones to find, but that doesn't mean they're going to look the same. Minecraft villages are going to be much more detailed, with better fortification to prevent mobs from attacking its population. Additionally, there are compact areas filled with valuable chest items. Outposts are generally useless in Minecraft for most players, but now they're an exciting place to visit. there are a ton of illagers to slay and chests and barrels to loot, offering players unique items. The surrounding environment is also changed, making it more of an outpost rather than just a random tower in the world. Instead of the simple vanilla pyramid, now you might encounter an enormous one with traps, chests, and rooms to explore. There's even a boss in the center of the structure to fight and overcome, making this an excellent adventure for players to enjoy. If you're having any trouble finding these biomes and structures, then you can use the plugin's commands. This is a list of commands that only the server operators can use. Terraform Generator's configuration is complicated since there's so much to tweak or toggle. For example, you might want to disable igloos or completely remove a certain biome from the world. Due to this large config, I definitely recommend checking out the official wiki for more information about each setting and to gain a better understanding of the generation. But here is at least how you're going to access the files in your panel. Head towards your FTP file access area from the main server panel, log in, and then head towards the plugins folder. From here, find and select the Terraform Generator directory, and then press edit to the far right of the config.yml file, and here is where you're going to make any changes. Once you're done, always make sure to save the file, and then you can head back to the main panel and restart the server to apply any of the changes. There could be a few causes for having world generation issues, with incorrectly setting up the bucket.yml file being a common one. Make sure you're copying the world's code at the bottom of the settings in the panel editor. If you want to be sure that it's right, you can also go to our written guide and copy and paste that section completely. For world name, make sure you aren't using a name that is already associated with an existing world. If you're using multiverse to generate the world, then make sure you're entering the correct G value. This is going to be the plugin's name, so in this case, it's Terraform Generator. If you are having any problems with the configuration, your biggest problem is probably going to be the formatting. Using capitalization for a toggle option isn't correct since it's only true or false. This also applies to spaces, typos, and anything else that might break the format. If you're sure the formatting is correct, then it could also be that you've exceeded the plugin's limits by either increasing or decreasing a value by too much. Definitely check out the wiki page so you know exactly what you're doing when changing these options. This is the perfect way to change up your scenery while also keeping the original gameplay you love, and with its configuration settings, there's even more that you can go over and change, so be sure to check it out. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.